You will lead me through the fire, and in darkest night, you were close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. Yeah.
Fire back up! Ah! set the captive free. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We ask you every one of you to come to pay your tithe step towards to be refined, and our last respect towards our late sister Catherine Catherine. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. We now turn over to Holy Ghost Deliverance Center or Sons of Praise and Worship. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God bless everybody. Hallelujah. Today we are here not to be sad, because our family is happy with the Lord. So we are to rejoice in the Lord. For the first time, hallelujah. As we sing the fourth song here, is the second song, it is Keep Thy Abundance. Hallelujah. There's a lot that is fairer than this.
Toilet will all be ended. Toilet will free up. Shadows will free away. Toilet will be forgotten. My Savior God. Good morning, everyone. Amen.
I'll be saying a poem. You never said you were leaving. You never said you were leaving. You never said goodbye. You were gone before we knew it, and only God knows why. A million times I cried. It's only till I have failed. A million times I needed you, a million times I cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life, I love you daily. In death, I love you still. In our hearts, you hold a place that only you can fill. It breaks my heart to lose you, but you didn't go alone. The part of me went with you the day God took you home.
You have next year, I'm seeing here a song speech. I don't think clear what it's about, but if I'm even know, it's a Mark song, then you have speech, and you have Grace, Sister Grace. I don't know, you all know who it is? So come on now, please. I'm not sure. Song speech, I don't know who it is. Song speech. Who it is? Come on now. Okay, sister.
I cannot remember some of their names,
But I remember this small one is Corey. And say, and the other girls, to take care of her children, real beautiful. Real beautiful. And sometimes she told me, "Greg, I'm going to church," but I never knew where the church was until now. But life must go on. I don't know if Gabriel is here. I can't remember him. Honestly, I can't remember him. And we had experience of very nice Catherine. And she lived with them for years. Don't get me back yet. And I gave God praise and thanks. A lot of things went on. A lot of things. But life goes on. And I pray God for the family and the ones who left behind. I pray God for them that they may get health and strength. God will give them health and strength that they could go on and live their life. Thank you very much.
Good morning to everyone that gathered this morning to celebrate the life of Catherine Caliber. Catherine, as I know her, that's my wife there, she was always a very polite person. I knew her since she was young, before she even had answers. We always be together most of the time. You should come and visit. I usually go and visit. At that point in time, she was living down at by where they have the Grace Plan. And we used to leave for the Spain and go and visit her. But since I get to know Catherine, she is a person always a giver. Nothing was too much for she to give.
Amen.
To love, to share.
Amen.
And this morning I want to tell the children that if they take one little step, like their mother, by having that great amount of love for people,
amen,
they cannot go wrong.
Amen.
She was a person with love. And most of all, she loved the church that she used to go. I can remember she used to leave and go to Tobago with the church. She used to go out brandy with the church. She never gave up her church. And I know today she is at rest.
Amen.
The angels of God,
oh God,
is taking her over on the other side. And she's not here. This is only part of what she's supposed to be. But Catherine in herself is with her maker.
Amen.
She is asleep. And those of us who work and do the things that God wants us to do, someday we'll be in paradise with her. We will meet someday. So to all the family, I want to tell you all, live good. Live in peace. Obey the rules of God at all times. Because as much as Catherine was a woman, she never liked partying. Gabriel had a wife that you can say, this is a wife. Because she was a devoted person to her children. I cannot remember one day that she ever leave her children after she going to a party. She was always a devoted person and loved. And we share that love over all the years until she gets sick. Well, because of transportation, we were not able to visit as and COVID comes down, so we were not able to visit as we should. But we always, being a visitor,
between Catherine and ourselves. Ansel used to come once in a while and visit us also. But then he has his family now, and I believe he is devoted to that family. But whatsoever, I want to say to them, live in love. Not love of the world, but the love of God. And God will take care of you. Because your mother was a loving person. Your mother shared that love among all who come into contact with. And today, you come to her our last visit and wish all the family a blessed and wonderful time as they travel this journey in this life. In Jesus' name, I thank you. Pastor.
Thank you, brother. Praise God. We now have next. If anybody get left out today, right? We're going to continue. But I'm not really leaving nobody. So Catherine had to get tribute. But I think all what happened here is what she wanted, I believe. So we have, I see here next we have Lisa, second tribute. If she's not wrong, come forward if she's not there. Okay? Alright. Yeah, then we have next, we have Ansel and Corey, some him, how great thou art. Okay? Ansel and
Present to everyone. I'm here to pay my tribute to my mom. Well, I'm not really a singer, but I'm going to say all that I can remember. Those days with mom were the best days of my life. I could recall that she was always standing by me in the garden. And she's always trying her best to sow that seed with me. But she always say, Corey, go ahead and plant. And what you plant is going to reap. And you're going to be able to feed your family. Never forget that. I recall that I was telling mom, I said, are you prepared? She turned and she tell me no. But I tell her that I believe in life after death. And I said, do you believe? And she said, yes. And I said, that is the most important thing.
Amen.
Once you believe that, I believe that too. But I believe that when someone is born, they're going to be born again. And I spend most of my time going to visit her, no matter where she was. And those last days was tragic to me. That I tell her, I say, a house could fall and break down. You can build back that. But when someone, when a loved one is born, it takes a lifetime to rebuild that. So I was in hospital with her. I was rubbing her hand. I didn't know where the prayer came from, but the situation that I saw her, the most I could do was just pray. And she squeezed my hand 3 times, she smiled. And that's when I know that I know my mother is saved. I can stand here and confess today that my mother dedicated her life to the Almighty Father. Because most of the days, even though she wasn't in church, she used to be home. And she was carrying a service home in the house, like if she was surrounded by everyone. And that brought joy to my heart. I really don't know. You know, it took me a lot to see my mom gone, that I never really get to spend most of the time. Because I say, if someone knows when a talent like this is going to happen, some might run, some might die, some might duck. But I know my mother was standing strong, and she was ready to give her life to Almighty Father. I just want to say that, Catherine, Talent, I know that the journey is long, but I know today that God has raised his whole army of angels. Because everyone is here waiting to gather you and take you to your full gate. I know suffering and pain is done. And the memories of me and you will never, never, never die as long as I live. And I hope that when my time comes, you are going to be there to accept me. That is all I got to say right now. Everyone, thank you all for being here. Thanks. Love.
Now we just have a little special message from our first daughter, who's got a niece, Lisa McKay, sorry.
Teacher, you always say to me that I have your ways and your love for children. Thank you for giving me that gift from you. I am blessed to have you as my mother. Your faith in Christ, I love that about you. You always praise God to the end. To my brothers and sisters, thank you very much for taking good care of Mom. Mom, I love you and miss you very much. Thank you for waiting on me. Rest in peace.
Thank you. Thank you, sister. That's one of sister. Lady sister, Catherine daughter, man. Also trained them beautiful and nice, man. God bless you, beautiful and nice children. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Okay. We have, I have here how great thou art. But I don't know if that song, they don't have to sing, I really don't know. If there are some, for daughter one, Akisha, how great thou art, we can sing it, but I don't know. If she wants to sing a song, she can just stand. I don't know. But okay, she just stand, it's okay. But we don't suppose that sing it, I don't know. Okay, so now we have an open floor. There are bright people who know Sister Catherine, who's preaching like, she was a powerful woman of God, you know. Then I'm on some Christians who need scandal. Some Christians, you're afraid to tell them X plus, because if you tell them X plus, they better tell them too. X plus, Y plus, T. Scandal. Sister Catherine was a real holy woman of God. And you are here in here with a sister, you know. What a loving sister, boy. Will you say, you know? Nice sister, man, God, nice. And she doesn't defend anybody. She said, no, Brother Harry is a good person. And somebody saying all things about Brother Harry. She said, no. Brother Harry, not so. I said, oh, I don't miss that sister. I don't miss. I want her to come back in the world. You know, God's prayer. God has taken the people who good from the beginning of that. God knows, okay, then they God pray. God said, everything given praise. You know what I mean? Yeah, that's to God. Hallelujah, but we'll miss that sister, man. Then I'm going to come back to that Katina. I'm not finished, though. I'll take 5 hours. Oh, hallelujah. Beautiful sister. So the friend open to, we have 3 persons, right? That will be saved from the Mr. Catherine, right? Very short, about 2-3 minutes. And the first column sister. Somebody request a song because I'm only 4 persons. Right? Somebody request a song to sing a song on behalf of Sister Catherine. Yes, I know very familiar. I'm not calling Sister Rachel to sing that song. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory to God, glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to God. Praise God.
Praise God, thank you, Jesus. Give you praise and I give you God honor and glory. I thank God because this is the day that He has made and we will rejoice and be glad in it in spite of. Amen? We all know that our sister has gone to be with the Lord. So, yes, some of us will be sad, but I am happy because I know she's in a better place. Amen?
Amen.
In the dark of the midnight, have I all hide myself while the storm and there's no
one second. Okay.
May the flash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry, keep me safe till the storm passes by. Oh, till the storm passes over and the thunder lands no more. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. It definitely is not before you know.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Till the storm passes over. Till the thunder sounds no more. Was a woman of faith.
Praise God.
And I know no matter what she went through or what she was going through, that she died with that faith.
Amen.
That faith believing that God is a rewarder to those that diligently seek after Him. Amen.
And she was an exemplar.
Amen. Through her struggles in life, she never gave up. She always hold on to Jesus. You can call Sister Catherine anytime. She always have an encouraging word to give.
Amen.
Amen. She always, you know, tell you, hold on, don't give up. God is good.
Amen.
God is great. Something good is going to happen. Amen. And she always, you know, she always there. No matter what, she always there. She go through her struggles in life. She stayed in the house of the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
No matter what her situation with her children, a loved one, she still remains herself present in the house of the Lord, because she always believes that they put God first in everything. Amen? And this is a good example. She was a good example for us to follow. Amen? My personal opinion is that she left good footsteps behind. Who want to walk in it? They will see her one day. Amen? She left good footsteps behind, and good footsteps are footsteps to trace.
Amen.
Amen. And I want to encourage each and everyone, our children, our family, our loved ones, don't give up. Hold on to Jesus. Amen. God is our comforter today, and He will comfort you, and He will take you through. Amen. No matter what, hold on to Jesus. She said that the example for our children. They saw her struggle, they were there with her, and they saw her hold on to the end. And that is important. The race is not for the swift, but it's for those that endure to the end. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God bless sister. No, you have to attack him for years now. No, for years. And next sister, she's coming to sing now, right? Very short and sweet. Sister, Glenda. Come on, Sister Glenda. Hallelujah. She has a sweet voice, you know.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Praise the Lord. Jesus.
Okay, we now have one sister.
sister, Captain Best Friend Man. That is Sister Hillary. Come on, Sister Hillary. Glory to God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank God for being in the house today. Hallelujah. Thank God for seeing each and every one of you here. Praise the name of the Lord. And you know, Sister Catherine was a real blessing to me. Hallelujah. I could never leave. Yes, sometimes. But I'm not feeling when I lifted to the back there at that time. And she didn't want to hear I got sick or anything. Praise the Lord. She always do something. She brought a set of fish to me. To cook, to say, eat it and strengthen your body. Hallelujah. This is the type of sister. And she always will witness. Hallelujah. She's a soul winner. Hallelujah. And as the Bible says, he that winneth soul is wise. This is what she was doing. Hallelujah. And I thank God for her. You know, the word of God said to be absent from this world is to be present with the Lord. And I thank God for her. And I pray that her children will continue to walk. Hallelujah. And I ask you all to back up these children in prayer. Praise the name of the children, the grandchildren. Hallelujah. And may God bless you today. She's a great sister. She's loving. She's so sweet. Hallelujah. And I have no fear. But I hear she passed away. I just know she's born with the Lord. Hallelujah. I didn't have to find out and say, I wonder where she gone. Hallelujah. I know she is. Jesus. God bless you.
She was so sweet and lovely and kind. Yes, but what do we have next now? We have our, we have Sister Patsy. What else is a Patsy? Great fellow, Sister Patsy. Come up here, man. God bless. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Well, truly, Sister Patsy was a good friend of mine. So close. After I tell her anything, nobody has to know that secret. She's really fear God. She doesn't want to talk much about people because she fear we will talk. Right? I know this is a pastor from a very young time. I know the children babies. And so it's my son. Because I stay by him. Right? Now you have to say you are next mother. And we will never forget those all those children. In prayer, we remember them. So I thank God for taking her. Yes? Because she knows best more than us. So I thank God for your God for her. I know I miss her, so this is not needed. I miss her. What will do? He gave and he take it. Amen. Praise God.
Praise God. We now have a eulogy. Yes, I know you take paper. A eulogy of the late Sister Catherine's son. And say hallelujah. Let him have a close man. Hallelujah. This strong man, God, keep them man. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Good afternoon, everyone. Our family, friends, and well wishers, good afternoon. To all the folks who may not know me, my name is Ansel Callis. I am my mom and first eldest son. Thank you all for coming here today and help us say goodbye to mom. To me, my mom was a true guiding light. She set the example of what a good wife and mother and friend should be. She would always give her last to someone in need in all walk of life and her path and her journey. For friends or individuals who are around her, will always say, Patrick is the person who respected the Lord.
Amen.
And everyone, she did her best and provided. And she always provided properly for her family. And there were six of us. She ensured quality time to keep of us, that digest that education, and to keep the Lord Jesus Christ at the center of our lives. I remember my mom used to keep. I remember my days when we used to come to church service here at church of the evening. We used to walk from my path. We used to come all the way up here to Derrick Road. When Stephen got his first three quarters of a gallon back in those times, and that is when our tall foot would have been of ease after we started to get to church on the 7 a.m., which we used to hold the service time up in the morning. Even if there was one piece of bread, should advise us to share with someone that's hungry on the
knee. Amen.
I remember everything that I could have been possible about my mother. As you all know, my mom had a great deal of faith and really missed church. Her dedication to the Lord was her passion. She truly believed she could pass through the raging waters and the seas and do not drown because God was with her. Even though her battle, she kept her eyes on the sparrow. Well, this is the end of your chapter, but not the end of your book. We all love you. Thanks for every lesson of life. From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, we are my turn to welcome you home to San Pedro.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. You're not calling Sister Catherine, the basis of Catherine. The very thing that Catherine daughter, Sister Akisha, do something. She knows how to pray. Sister Akisha, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory.
Blessed morning to everyone. I want to give God thanks and praise. My name is Jessette Free. I am her first niece. My mom, Frederica Free, was the first of all the children. And I did not grow up with Aunt Catherine, but when I got to know her, my Lord, it has been growing and growing and growing and growing. She's just a woman of great faith, always encouraging you, always, no matter what she's going through. She always have a word of encouragement. She always encouraged me in the Lord to keep in the Lord and family. Tell me, keep in touch with Lisa, keep in touch with your cousins. Always, always, always. And I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for her. She has impacted my life. I have shared her testimony. Even in the midst of going through this situation, she was always encouraging, a woman of great faith. So we no longer mourn as if we would never see her again, because to be absent from this body is to be present with our Lord. And we know that she loved the Lord. She talked about him. She shared about him. She encouraged to serve him. So I encourage those of you who are there, those of you who are listening, if you do not yet know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, I pray that you will accept him before the time is too late, because this was her greatest joy. She loved the Lord. She served the Lord. So be encouraged. Each and every one of you know that you will see her again. In the arms of sweet deliverance, I'm gonna lay my heavy burdens down. And with my Lord, I'll abide. Ah, when at last my traveling days are done, in the land somewhere beyond the sun, in the arms of sweet deliverance, in the arms of sweet deliverance, I shall rest. By and by, of troubles I had and more than enough, and many a days my path is rough, and therefore I just wondered what to do. But then I talked to my Lord in prayer. He answered me that he's right there, and whatsoever may come, he'll see you through. Boom, boom, boom. In the arms of sweet deliverance, I'm gonna lay my heavy burdens down. And with my Lord, I'll abide. Ah, when at last my traveling days are done, in the land somewhere beyond the sun, in the arms of sweet deliverance, in the arms of sweet deliverance, I shall rest. By and by. Amen and amen. She's resting in the arms of her sweet deliverance. Be blessed, be encouraged, and know that God is with you. A blessed morning to everyone. I want to give God thanks and praise. My name is Gisette.
Resting in the arms of her sweet deliverance. Be encouraged.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Yes, DJ. Come on, man, DJ. You're gonna hear the man of God now. But I Stephen, but I saw Catherine, great friend in the Lord. Hallelujah. You can see some Catherine said, Dr. Dancer. Yeah, we can't believe Pastor. Yes, sir, man, you can't pass yes, sir, hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. What song? And let me say of God, humble servant, a great servant, Sister Catherine, but a team back of them, hallelujah. Glory to God, hallelujah. And a real friend, two friends, hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. She said, Lord, dance and sing, man, hallelujah. Jesus! Jesus! Peter, and then she put up the graphic with Peter. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. And so now we have the eulogy by Corinne and Petra. By Corinne.
Good afternoon, family, friends, and well wishers. Remembering the life and legacy of the Queen, where do I start? I contemplate this for a few days, but words continue to fail me. I can write a book on what mom meant to me. My name is Corinne Talese, and I am the daughter of Catherine Talese. I am the fourth of the six siblings, and I am honored to take a moment to tell you about the life of my incredible, exceptional, blessed mother, which I was lucky to call mom. Catherine Talese was born to Viola and Christian Derrick on the 4th of April, 1954. She was admitted at the St. Kingstown General Hospital in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. But not everyone knows she was actually born in the Grenadines. My mom came to Trinidad at a very tender age in 1966. She came with her big sister, my aunt, Auntie Gracie. Likewise, her mother, Viola Pompey, was already a citizen of Trinidad and Tobago. Mom had her first daughter in 1972, which is my eldest sister, Lisa Pompey. Thereafter, she met her first love, Gabriel Talese. And there her journey began. What can I say about the world's greatest mother? Mom was honorable, she was kind, she was more than fair, she was sweet, passionate, she was gentle. And always have a broad smile, loving. Oh gosh, don't speak about giving. She always gave her last. When I tell you her last, her last. A woman of gratitude, humble, upright in the things of God. We all are not perfect, but she always had that agape love for an individual that displayed it daily. To me, when time was up, she told me on a daily basis, be good to yourself. Mom worked hard at everything she put her hands to do, created magic. Oh gosh, her fudge. I remember she would make fudge, and we will help her just to get the pot. To lick it, and she said, I don't need to wash this puff, it's already clean. My mother boy, why now? Mom was blessed, anointed, and appointed for God's workmanship. Never liked to stay at home on a Sunday from church. She loved her life, she loved her children and her grandchildren. Touch one of us, my God, she will breathe like a dragon for you, always protecting her children. I know we have all heard this before and haven't really realized it until now, that life is a lot shorter than any of us realize. And you just don't know what you have until it's gone. I miss her terribly. I love the time that I spent with her. When she told her story, we would laugh so much till we cry. A simple woman, incredible, even a role model and a mother to others. It's sad that she's gone, but I know she's not in pain anymore. But I just want her to tell me she was leaving. It's not easy to say goodbye to the one you love, to the one that birthed you. I miss you, Mom, and I love you. You will forever be my hero. Your last words you said to me, my motivation is to go on. God loved you, and now you're home. I understand to be absent in the body is to be present with the Lord. To my family, the last thing she said, don't give up on me. We didn't. We prayed. We prayed. We tried. But God said it's over. In closing, Luke 1:37 says, for God with nothing shall be impossible. If we as a family can put our trust in God, we can and will get through everything. While on the ride to a life, you have to take the good with the bad and smile. When you're sad, love what you got and remember what you have. and always remember to forgive. Thank you.
And now we call on Carlos to say a few words.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. My name is Carlos Ferrer. Since I got to meet a very, very good friend of myself and my family. I know actually about 45 years now. I can take care of my children, like me and my wife divorced. He take care of my grandchildren too, and my next grandchildren too. Actually, was always a lovely person. It was the most important thing, she always talked about her family. Every time she comes to me, Carlos, boy, I pray for my son, I pray for my children. I want to make sure that good and serious, let them love God. He said that my greatest desire is to see them serve and worship and glorify God. She always cried tears. But this one that's sitting down here, I don't forget his name. She always spoke about him. I think that was she loved him, son. She loved him so much that she always, always spoke about him. Patrick was a person who always shared anything she had. If Patrick come and she said, Carlos, come and sit down, let me talk. We talk about our family, we talk about our job, we talk about our friends, and most importantly, we talk about church. She always speak about the house of the Lord and that place of worship and glorify God. Through a good time, through a bad time, she always worship the Lord. And that's a very, very good thing about Patrick. She encourages us to serve and worship God. Let God is the most important thing in your life after your family. And she always talks about children with the blood of Jesus Christ. She always talks about her grandchildren that she has, how she loves them. I also want to see them grow up and be something in life. Now she has gone to become makers. I want you all to remember one important thing. Patrick wants her children to serve God. Regard that anything else. And for our brother and sister who are alive today, I hope that we take the time to pray for them, to encourage them, and they walk in the land of the living and praise God. That was always Patrick's dream. Brothers and sisters, we don't know when we are leaving this world. But one thing which always leave with a great history that people will remember us for the good things that we do, for the people that we encourage, for the people that we love. And in all things, give praise and thanks to the Almighty. Ask all these things in no other name but the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And all God people say, Amen. And amen.
Thank you, Carlos. It's
goodness, His love and kindness. Before I preach this message, I still have the wife sitting down there. One thing I can say about Sister Catherine, as the psalmist David said, I was glad when they say, let us go into the house of God. And the word of God said, do not neglect the assembling of yourself together. And why we come together is because there is something taking place.
Praise God.
If we walk in the light, as He is in the light, and we have fellowship one with another, the blood of Jesus Christ is cleansing us.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And even as we in church, God is doing something.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I saw Brother Ansel talk about the gallant. When I got saved, I meet Catherine as a believer in Christ, Sister Catherine. And when I go back in the time I probably saved now, I'm already 44 years in the Lord.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. So I don't know how long before she got saved. Hallelujah. And even one thing I must have done, I would have been the transport person. Hallelujah. Even for that, we're not part of the 40-something years. And I give God thanks and praise.
Praise God.
Because God said again, a cup of water to the least of these my disciples, you shall in no wise lose your reward.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I read part of the testimony that Sister Uma said. You know, sometimes you're doing things for God, but you consider yourself an unprofitable servant. It's just that the Lord kindness is in places. And I was surprised that Sister Catherine, she said, once I come back, I want to go and do the work of an evangelist. I want to make full proof. You see, the harvest is plenty, you see? But the laborers are few. And we have always have to pray to God that He send laborers in His disarmament. We have plenty of people who say they know God, but they ain't going out there. And yet He commissioned us to go into all the world to preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. He that believeth not shall be damned. And we all want to believe the word of God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. I want to go into the book of Luke. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. And I read in Luke chapter 12, verse 13. And remember, this message is not for the dead. It's for us who live in. And the word of God have faith in it. So faith comes by hearing, and by hearing the word of God. And Luke chapter 12, verse 13. And one of the company said unto him, Master, speak to my brother that he divide inheritance with me. And he said unto him, Man, who made me a judge or a divider over you? And he said unto them, Take heed and beware of covetousness, for a man's life consists not in the abundance of the things which he possesses. The message here is, take heed and beware of greed, of covetousness, for a man's life does not consist on his earthly possession. And it's very important for us to understand that. But when we look at this message, we look at a man who was hurt. His father or somebody, family member, had died. And for some reason, his own brother didn't want to share the inheritance. His own brother took the inheritance for himself. And I can tell you, sometime in our funeral, the worst part of it is the inheritance. It could split family. It could cause family not to talk to one another. Many family will be vexed. How come you get that and I didn't get it? Hallelujah. And all because of himself, the spirit that dwell in man love to envy him. And we have to understand, it's not about earthly possession here. Because the man with the earthly possession, he can't take the two of them. Hallelujah. And even Solomon said that is real vanity and vexation of spirit. Because you might store all the wealth and somebody foolish come and spend on all of it. Hallelujah. This man came to Jesus Christ. He stood at old meeting. He said that Jesus Christ might be able to speak because because Jesus Christ is a man of justice. Because if he walked as a man, he preached the word of God. Everywhere he went, he was doing good. And he came to Jesus. And it was an absurd thing, eh? Because if you get the message was preaching and he stopped it, he said, Lord, speak to my brother. He wanted everything for himself. And you could know he was good. And Jesus Christ used that same request to show us the importance of life. And that is why he said, take heed and beware of covetousness, for a man like consists not in the abundance of things which he possess. And Jesus Christ went and showed a parable on that. And I'll paraphrase it. He started to talk about a man who the Lord started to bless. And he seemed to be a businessman, like a farmer. He had his barns. His barns couldn't take the amount of goods he had anymore. So he decided to himself, he speak to himself. And I want to say it's important for us to consult God.
Amen.
In everything we do,
amen,
we could consult God. He spoke to himself. And he began to be selfish. He said, that small man I have, I will get rid of it. You know, when I look at that, he could have said, I will give that to a servant or somebody in need, because he had to break it down anyhow. But he broke it down and he built a bigger barn. And then when you look at the goods, you know you couldn't spend it. I mean, they say most of us ain't in that class. We still have to work day by day. But this man reached that point that he could have said, when he store his goods, he could take his ease. And what he was looking at, he had many goods stored for many years. He could eat, drink, and be merry. He could go into retirement. Hallelujah. He was only studying the earthly possession. He failed to realize that one day the appointment of death will take place. And when death took place, death called him a fool. The Bible says, a fool has said in his heart, there is no God. Not that you don't love God, but in your works you deny him. So in your heart you say, there is no God, you have no time for God. This parable that Jesus speaks, this man doesn't have no time for God. He was more thinking about his worldly possession. He was more thinking about how he could enjoy himself on the face of the earth. And many of us, we don't have that possession. But all we're thinking about, pleasures of sin, past season, that is just past season. One day I have to stand before God. This man didn't know the day. He was well off. Hallelujah. But that very night, the bread left him. And he ended up facing his maker. And remember, we all have to stand before the judgment seat of Jesus Christ to give account for whatsoever we do in this body, whether it be good, whether it be evil. Because everything is recorded. We heard the message from Sister Naomi. Everything is recorded. So we have no excuse. This man had it nice. He only think about himself. He didn't think about them coming to the house of God. He didn't think about consulting God. Hallelujah. And Jesus Christ said, When he looked at him, he said, so is he. Let me just read that part. Hallelujah. Verse 21. So is he that lay up treasures for himself and is not rich towards God. And he said unto his disciples, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you should eat, neither your body, what you should put on. The life is more than meat, and the body more than raiment. Consider the ravens. Consider the birds. God take care of them. And this man, he ended up not storing up things in heaven. And the most important thing in life is the riches then. God expects us to store riches in heaven. How are we doing that? We have to receive Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And we can't say we receive him. We have to be a follower of Christ. We say we love him. We are the keeper's commandment. If we haven't made it in heaven, and the Bible says, eyes have not seen or heard, neither have it entered into the heart of man, the thing which God has provided for us. So we see it. He has some treasure here. He was better off than everybody else. And he didn't realize the real treasure is up in heaven. You're walking on streets of gold. No more pain, no more suffering.
Hallelujah.
I want to make sure I make it here. I don't know about you. I ain't taking no chance. Because this very moment, my soul could be required of me. Hallelujah. And then we see another account that Jesus Christ said, it's very hard for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. The poor have the gospel preached to them, but we don't know we're rich. We are rich in heavenly places, isn't it? Through Christ Jesus. This man, he had everything, a young ruler. And he came to Jesus Christ because he knew that he was lacking something. He said, good master, what must I do to inherit eternal life? And Jesus Christ told them, you know the law of Moses, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not commit fornication, honor your mother and father. And you know the man said, all these things I do for my youth up. He better than plenty of us, boy. Because I can remember different things when I was small. I could remember lying to get away. And Jesus Christ knew he was talking the truth to him. Jesus Christ loved him for that. But he said, one thing you have. Sell all that you have. Give it to the poor and follow me. And you will have treasures in heaven. And I said, what? My earthly possession? I could turn to a big rock. I might be in need. Hallelujah. And he failed to realize the most important thing is storing up treasures in heaven. Hallelujah. Failed to realize that. He went away sorrowful because he had many possessions. Hallelujah. It's so important for us to store treasures in heaven. Even one thing I know about Sister Patrick, she would have said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. One of his sons said, listen now, the devil wants to take my mother's faith. But I know she fight it to the end. The just shall live by faith. Remember, will you tell me that answer? The just shall live by faith.
Hallelujah.
We all have to go this way. The man who had all the things, he didn't have to study how to spend. He had too much to spend. like to share. Many of us would like to share. Sister Patrick still used to share. Look, Sister Hillary said she wasn't feeling good and she got some fish. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. This man didn't like to share. But he failed to realize we had to meet the maker. Are we prepared to meet the maker? If God said, this day thy soul is required of you, where will you spend your eternity? That's a soul searching question. We had a question. We had to examine ourselves. Because if we die this moment, a lot of times we hear people say, listen, I love God. But it's more than that.
Amen.
You can't love him and be fornicated.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You can't love him and be gambling and drinking and smoking. I mean, say you know about it. But when you come in contact with him, when you come in contact with him, every man in Christ is a new creature. I am a living example of that.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. All things are passed away. Behold, all things become new.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. We all want to make heaven our home. But this life is not guaranteed us. If we live 3, 4, and 10, and even we have 20 centurions living over 100 years. Hallelujah. And this is a true story. This man was well wealthy. And he made his will. And he had his lawyer. And when he showed up all his wealth, he put in the will that so much $1 million had to go down any casket, because you know you're going to be in a big nice casket. Right, so you pick every day, you say, $3 million had to go with me in my casket. So the time of the funeral now, the lawyer now telling the wife who is the executor, hey, you forget he saved $3 million. But the executor was wise. She said, I have it. Where did she put? Is a check for $3 million, you can't spend that. Hallelujah. She know that if that money is up, that's not big figures, no, we are some. No, we are talking about them. Hallelujah. They're going down for that too. They're going down the secret in the land. Because it's covetousness. If the man was covetous, to think that when he go in the afterlife, he has some money to spend. It's either hell or it's either hell. It's an order in between. Some people say you have other holes in place and we go pray for you. And after that you go come out from there and go to hell. It can't work. It can't work. It's judgment. Now is the time. Now is the day of salvation. Don't wait until tomorrow. Tomorrow can be too late. I just want to say a word of prayer as I close. Hallelujah. Father, dear God, I thank you for your word. You say, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of your mouth. And Lord, even as the word go forth, and we heard some of the testimonies that Sister Catherine prayed and her desire is that her children should be saved. You know she always been praying. We hear from Mother Carlos. She always been praying for her children to surrender all to you. It's not that they don't know you. Many of them trying to strive to enter into the straight gate. I want to bring the family members in front here. So I pray. I want to get Sister. Sister Naomi, come up now, brother. Okay. The family members, if they can come in front. All the grandchildren can come too. Who link? Right? In laws. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Good. Sister, everybody. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father Lord, if you just stretch our hands to them as we start in this prayer. Father Lord, even as we lift up the family members before you, sometimes we don't even realize we have a treasure in the vessel until the outward man perish. And we heard it in the urology. And Father Lord, we pray that the legacy of Sister Katrin and our prayer and our heart desire for our children to surrender all to you. She grow them up to know you. And Lord, we come against every hindrance, every barrier in the name of Jesus, every obstacle in the way. We bind every spirit that is not of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus, we command strongholds to be broken. We command spiritual wickedness, we cast it out in the name of Jesus. And we pray, Lord, that your spirit of conviction will rest upon this family, Lord. That they will say individually, what must I do to be saved? They say individually, I surrender all to you. And Lord God, even as we pray this prophet, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We give you the honor and the glory for hearing and for answering, and God, for delivering, for loosing and setting free that drug addiction, everything that needs to be loose, Lord. And God, we pray for unity. Even as there might be some small inheritance, and I know, I don't know how big it is. It could be a chain. It could be a bracelet. Father Lord, we pray that the devil has no fighting for that. We bind that spirit in the name of Jesus. And we pray, Father, that unity will take among the family. In Jesus' holy precious name. Amen. And you may be seated as I pass back over to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. You are worthy to be praised.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You said, Praise God. They have come to faith. Praise God.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, we are about to see the body of our late sister. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But we have certain things to be done by your freedom body. We first pay our daughter son while you're free for your body. And then after, choose our son after, right? Okay? So, what I'm going to say, I'll be calling for you in question to send me some AI writing to put the answer to show. Because should we start off with a teacher's request, a song we'll be playing now, why else we'll bring your body, you're coming for that. And then, our children take some, right? Why people bring us on and anybody can bring over some of the playing, hallelujah. And we know they are going, the casting will be going to it's a casting home, and then after the cemetery, right? And there are still victims over in the cemetery, after the cemetery, so it's
sacrifice. Hallelujah. Pray now, son. Praise God. The person in control of the castle over me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're coming. All that coming. All that people. You're coming. The rush. We are there every time. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Something so strong. chasing no other. When I come to the end of myself, Father, help me. Father, help me. When I dead in Christ shall rise. No grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down. When the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, no grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down. Yes, no grave can hold my body down. When the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, no grave can hold my body down. Yes, no grave can hold my body down. My Lord, no grave can hold my body down. When the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down. Praise God. No grave can hold my body down. When the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, no grave can hold my body down.
Hallelujah.
Someday, someday, I go where Jesus lives. Someday, I go where Jesus lives. Someday, I go where Jesus lives. I be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him in the air. Yes, I be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him. Joy and happiness, peace of mind. Someday in glory, I tell a story, caught up to meet him in the air. Yes, we be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him. Joy and happiness, peace of mind. Someday in glory, I tell the story, caught up to meet him in the air. Yes, we'll be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him. Joy and happiness, peace of mind. Someday in glory, I tell the story, caught up to meet him in the air. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory to God. When Jesus call me, I will answer. Yes, I will answer to my name. When Jesus call me, I will answer. I will answer to my name. I will be somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping with my Lord. I will be somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping with my Lord. When Jesus call me, I will answer. I will answer to my name. When Jesus calls me, I will answer. I will answer to my name. I will be somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping with my Lord. I will be somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping, somewhere sleeping with my Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the sweet by and by, praise God, we shall meet beautiful shore. Yes, in the sweet by and by. Yes, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. Oh, in the sweet, yes, by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. Yes, in that sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. Yes, in that sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. Oh, in the sweet by and by. Yes, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. Yes, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. Goodbye, world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I make up my mind to go this way the rest of my life. I make up my mind to go that way the rest of my life. Born, born, born again. Thank God I'm born again. Born again. Thank God I'm born again. Praise the Lord. Over to Pastor Steve.
Alright, we're here to commit the body to the grave, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. But before we do that, I want to just go into the scripture. And I want to go into First Corinthians chapter 1 verse 15 First Corinthians chapter 15 verse 33 to 55. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that it is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? What we're seeing here is the earthly remains of our dearly departed. Her parents would have given her, and also probably her AK name or her home name, Agatha, that we on this side don't really know. But God also have a name written down for all of us. Hallelujah. And one thing God has called us, and God has called her home, but when she leave here, and I'm using the relu, the relu is the spirit of you, or the soul. She left here with all her senses. And God also prepared an incorruptible body. This body is subject to corruption. That body is incorruptible. And because it's incorruptible, we can only die once. And this is this death. Because that body is immortal. Hallelujah. This is a mortal body. So even though we're viewing her remains, and I like to put it in the right perspective. We expect everybody who accept Christ making it to heaven. Eh? But the scripture also say, not everyone that say, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of God. But they that do the will of the Father, which is in heaven. And we profess that Sister Catherine would have done the will of the Father. And that incorruptible or immortal body is somewhere in heaven rejoicing. Sometimes we use the word sleep, eh? But to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. All right. But if the body got a body and end up in the wrong place, because you have celestial body and terrestrial body, and that wrong place is right down in the heart of the earth. The bottomless pit, there's an entrance right on earth. And we heard the message yesterday. Locusts came out from that pit. We, as we're looking at this, committing the body, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, we are saying that one day we have to go this way. And if we go this way, we want to have a celestial body that will be going up to heaven. We don't want to have a terrestrial, immortal body. We still wouldn't be subject to death. But the Bible says, where the worm dieth not, and the fire is not quenched, we don't want to be there. That place wasn't made for man, but for the devil and his angels. At this time, we still have viewing, those who want to view. And then we are going to commit anybody. So I'll ask one of the sisters just to raise her song. Hallelujah.
We shall have a grand time up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time. Walking with the angel. Shout hallelujah. We
shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time. Walking with the angel. Shout hallelujah. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time. Walking with the angel, shouting hallelujah. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sea, by and by, we shall be on that beautiful shore. In the sea, by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sea, by and by, we shall be on that beautiful shore. Hallelujah. Amen.
All right, praise God. I think we finished the viewing now. All right, we could close up. Anybody want a view for the last? Speak now. Nothing like a wedding ceremony. Hallelujah. All right, we understand that this body has to go back to the dust of the earth. And as the Lord the body, I want all of us to pray. Hallelujah. And let's pray for one another, because this is the way of all flesh. I saw all the flowers went in the coffin, and I said, boy, if Sister Patrick didn't get flowers, she'd get flowers. And most of the time, we had to be thankful to God. Alright, do I want to sing a song? Alright, there's a special song to play while they're going down there, and then after I will do the commitment. You all could proceed.
Do that slow. Strength is when the road is long and heavy, when it's dark and darkened, see clearly I will lift mine eyes to thy ear. From into my hand, come my
hand. From you. You go ahead and let me. Father, dear God, we lead me all. Even as the undertaker of the dear path, Lord. Lord, we say this prayer because we know that you are here, your holy angels are here, you have appointed people to be here to show their respect. And Lord, as we commit Sister Catherine Pompey Callis back to where she come, dust to dust and ashes to ashes, we thank you, Lord, for your goodness and for your mercies and for your loving kindness, in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
from whence my command, my help comes from you. Lead me all, lead me out, lead me on to where I've never been before, a place I've never seen before. When I come to the end of myself, Father, carry me.
Carry me over. And it hurts so